Today, we'd like to show you how to navigate, set up, and configure a basic access point and client connection between two Antaira wireless devices. We will be using two ARS7131s for both examples, but this tutorial will apply to other Antaira wireless models as well. First, we are going to configure the access point by plugging into the Ethernet port on the device. If the unit has factory default settings, then DHCP is enabled on this port, and you should get an IP address. Next, using a web browser, log into the unit using the default IP address. In this case, it's 192.168.1.1. You'll be prompted for a username and password, which is on the label. On the first page, you'll see the router's IP address, subnet, gateway, and DNS. Scrolling down, you'll also see the DHCP settings that are enabled by default. For this example, we are going to leave all settings default and continue on the wireless tab. This page is where you can change the wireless mode from the drop-down menu. We're going to select an AP. For wireless network mode, we're going to leave this on mixed. We will change the SSID for this tutorial purpose, and all other settings can be left on default. Now we scroll down and make sure to save the changes we made. The next tab we need to configure is wireless security. This is where you choose your security mode. We are going to choose WPA and WPA2 Personal. Down here at the WPA Shared Key is where we can change the password. We are just going to leave it to default for now and save. After saving, make sure to also hit Apply Settings, so if the device is ever powered off, it will retain the changes made. Now we can take a look at the Status tab to see our changes. Click on Wireless and just verify that your settings are here. You'll notice at the bottom that there is no traffic or client yet. That's what we will set up on the next unit. So let's boot up the second unit and log into it. Now with this, we want to mimic a real-world scenario, where the client device would most likely be on a different network. So we can have a LAN and a WAN side. We are going to change the IP address on this unit to 172.168.1.1. For example, you'll notice the DHCP addressing is not updated, but it will be after we save and apply these settings. So now that we changed the router's IP address, we will have to re-log in to the new address at 172.168.1.1. Remember that we still have the DHCP enabled, so we should get a new IP address. Okay, so now we are back in, and you should see that the DHCP is now giving out 172 addresses. Let's go ahead and change the wireless mode to the client, and leave everything else to default for now, and save. Now we need to connect to the SSID of the access point we set up earlier. To do that, go to this wireless site survey button at the top, and a new window should open. This window will show all available networks we can connect to. So we will look for the one we created earlier and click join, and you should receive this successfully joined message. You will also see that the SSID changed here to the one we selected. Go ahead and save and apply these settings. We also need to match the security settings, so So go to the wireless security and make sure to match these settings to the access point and hit save and apply. Now you should notice that some LED indicator lights will turn on both devices. These lights show the signal strength and connection, but it's better to check the status tab, which we will do. Looking under the status tab, again, make sure all your settings are correct here. And at the bottom, you should see a wireless node. So both units are now connected, but there is one more thing we need to do. If you remember, we had DHCP enabled on the access point. So we want the client to also get a DHCP address. If you look at the top right, you will see WAN disabled. We need to enable this now. To do this, go back to the setup tab and click this dropdown for WAN connection type and select DHCP. Now, if you do not want to use DHCP, you can select static and manually enter an address yourself. Make sure to save and apply this. And now we are looking for our DHCP address in the top right. To verify that the connection works, just open a new tab in your browser and log into the access point unit at the 192 address. That's all for this tutorial. Thank you for purchasing and setting up your Antaira wireless device.